Tips, tips, tips with Tony. Tips, tips, tips with Tony. All about nutrition from your favorite dietitian. Everything you need to digest in your mind. Tips, tips, tips with Tony. Tips, tips, tips with Tony. Making you healthier one bite at a time. With Tony, tips. With Tony, tips. With Tony. Woo. Hello, and welcome to the Tips with Tony podcast. I'm Tony Marinucci, your registered dietitian, helping you get healthy one bite at a time. I am in the middle of taking an insane productivity course by Darren Hardy. Darren Hardy is someone, he's actually the owner of Success Magazine, and he literally interviews multi-millionaires and billionaires and just people who have made tremendous impact in the world on an ongoing, regular basis. People like Richard Branson, Bill Gates, Oprah. I mean, honestly, guys, anybody that you know who's made a significant impact in this world, he's interviewed them. So think about all of those thousands of interviews, and everyone that's successful in those has very similar themes. And this podcast is actually not going to be about like those things they have in common, although I do want to do another episode about that. This podcast is actually going to be about one of the things that I learned through taking Darren's Insane Productivity course. He also has daily videos you can watch every morning. He calls them Darren Dailies, you know, Monday through Friday. Whenever I open up my email, my inbox, it's the first video that I listen to. And then I watch, and it really just jumpstarts my day and gets me thinking about, you know, inspiring things, motivating things, and overall, he's just a really, really great guy. So most of the time when I record podcasts and put out content, a lot of it really does come from myself. But I mean, I'd be lying if I wasn't saying I was partly influenced by other people who helped my message out there. This exact method and message is straight from Darren, so I'm not taking credit for it. It's just something that I've actually started implementing in my life. I'm pretty new to it, but really, really finding it really helpful. And I wanted to kind of talk about kind of the importance of accountability, but also kind of the myths of what people think they need in an accountability buddy. So before I give you the actual strategy of kind of like your 30-minute system check-in with your accountability buddy, I definitely wanted to just first kind of share with you some things that I thought was kind of interesting and surprising when I was watching this video. So what he says is that your accountability buddy actually doesn't have to be someone who you look up to. It doesn't have to be someone who's a mentor or, you know, has this thriving business or is kind of like what's quote unquote above you. And it also doesn't have to be somebody, like, it doesn't matter kind of actually, like, it could be, but really the accountability buddy is someone who maybe they're just starting out. Maybe you're a business owner for 2 or 3 years and they're brand new in the game, or maybe they're in completely different industries. Maybe it's just like your friend that you're just like, hey, I need help making sure that I do my things and I need someone to be accountable. And maybe like you're working on a health and fitness goal and they're working on making sure that they stay on task with their like work goal or whatever it is. So like their job. And they can be completely different goals in completely different industries. So if like my friend works in retail and she's working on her retail goals and I'm working on my fitness goals, they don't have to be related and you don't have to be on the same level. I thought that was really interesting. So anyways, my accountability buddy I just talked to is actually going to be my boyfriend. We sat down together last weekend to really do this, and I'm excited to follow up again this week to kind of see if in fact we were successful or not and we did our things. But I definitely, you know, we like wrote in this notebook that we're going to leave on my counter table. And one time I took the book with me and I didn't even realize. And he's like, hey, I thought we were going to leave the book here. And it's true. Like we both need it because we need to be reminded of what we said we were going to do. So now when we check in with each other, we actually stay on task. So I think that it's really, really important. Whoever your accountability buddy is, it's someone that's going to actually keep you accountable and is reliable. So it doesn't matter what industry they're from. It doesn't matter what level there are in their business. None of that actually matters other than the fact that you guys are going to commit to meeting once a week for 30 minutes. doesn't need to be an hour. And if it finish, if you finish talking about what you're, what you said you were going to do in less than 30, then that's great. But it has to happen in, for 30 minutes. Probably easier if you pick same day, same time, but obviously schedules are flexible. So as long as you just maybe make your appointment to meet again the following week. So just as long as you're meeting once a week and you have 30 minutes or less together, it could be on a phone, it could be video conferencing, and it, or it can be in person. So for me and my boyfriend, it's in person. So what we're, I'm going to teach you is kind of what to write out. So if you're driving right now, I would definitely have you pause and listen to this when you're not driving, or re-listen to it when you're not driving, or pull over and take a few notes. So what you're going to do is you're going to write out your three wins. So three things that you're proud of that you've accomplished that you said you were going to do. Your losses, so three losses or three opportunities of things that didn't get done that you wanted to accomplish, kind of your misses. Three fixes, so how you are going to improve on those opportunities or make changes to make sure that whatever you said you were going to do actually gets done the following week. Three lessons learned. And it's helpful, you can split it up into buckets, or you can just do three general lessons. But the buckets that Darren had suggested was a lesson learned in business, a lesson learned in leadership, and a lesson learned in relationships. And then lastly, your favorite message from personal development. So this is to make sure that you're always listening to something that's motivating, that's inspiring, and that's teaching you. So Darren Hardy, obviously, it's easy if you watch Darren Hardy every morning because you could just talk about your favorite Darren Hardy message. But I'm like a huge person. I'm always listening to an audiobook. I'm always listening to podcasts. I'm always reading something inspiring or inspirational. So what this does is it forces me to really focus and think about like which one was my actual favorite. It really helps me to pay attention and being able to translate that. And so obviously it also makes sure that I'm always listening to personal development. Okay. So I'm going to repeat those one more time, just in case you are driving or you're writing it down and you want to kind of go back, or you don't have to go back. You could just listen. So you're going to, each week you're going to sit down with your accountability partner. You are going to time it, so no more than 30 minutes. You are gonna, one person's gonna share, then the next person's gonna share, okay? And if you want help and to help each other, that's fine, but it's really, that's actually not for it. This is actually to help you stay accountable to yourself and what you're gonna do. That's why they don't have to be the same industry or anything like that. They might not know how to help you. You have to learn how to help yourself, but this kind of gives you some guidance and keeps you focused and productive and on task. So your three wins, your three losses, your three fixes, three lessons learned, and your favorite message from personal development. All right, guys, I hope you found this helpful. If you're not already in my Healthy Lifestyle Support Group on Facebook, I strongly encourage you to join, because in that free support group, there, that's how we help hold each other accountable. But there's plenty of people in there that if you went in and just been like, hey, I just listened to Tony's podcast, I'm looking for an accountability buddy, they'd be, I'm sure you'll find someone. And it's also a great way to connect with other people, people from all over the world in that group, not even all over the country. You know, most people that follow me are from the US, but there are also all people from outside of the US. And it's just a really great way to make connections and connect with someone you maybe never would have known before, which is also really powerful because you never know what you can learn from somebody else. All right, guys, I hope you found this helpful. If you have any other questions, please don't hesitate to reach out to me. You can email me, tipswithtony@gmail.com. If you're not already subscribed to the podcast, please subscribe. And if you're feeling extra generous, maybe write a review. It allows other people to find the podcast. Give it a 5-star rating. The more people that know about the podcast, the more this message of helping you get healthier one bite at a time is actually possible. Thank you so much for your support. As always, this is Tony Marinucci, your registered dietitian, helping you get healthy one bite at a time.